Hi, I'm Navneet. I'm a principal specialist at AWS, and I work with healthcare and life sciences customers on building data strategies, including modern data governance and federated data ecosystems.
Hi, I'm Subrat. I'm a senior solutions architect at AWS, and I work with healthcare and life sciences customers. Today, we are going to introduce you to a new feature within Amazon DataZone called Custom AWS Service Blueprint. Prior to Custom AWS Service Blueprint feature release, DataZone supported three types of environments out of the box: default data warehouse environment, default data lake environment, and default SageMaker environment targeting personas like data scientists and analysts. Environments in a DataZone project provide the infrastructure, that is tools, storage, and IAM permissions for the project members. Before adopting Amazon DataZone, customers have been managing data pipelines using their own customized IAM roles for their data management operations, such as storing data in Amazon S3, performing AWS Glue ETL jobs, Amazon EMR Studio for data processing, and so on. Hence, customers wanted to bring their own IAM roles and resources to Amazon DataZone. Custom AWS Service Blueprint feature gives them a mechanism to specify and use their own customized IAM role to connect to their existing AWS resources to perform data operations. Customers can also configure AWS Service Blueprint to bring their own resources, such as databases, as data sources and subscription targets to enhance governance across these assets as well. With this release, administrator can configure data sources and subscription targets in Amazon DataZone console and not restricted to do those actions in the data portal. Let's dive into an example of a customer business use case from life sciences research domain, where we will showcase downloading of files using Amazon S3. Customers often create catalog of their raw genomic sequence files and secondary processed files such as genomic variant files. Downloading those files individually would be a tedious and time-consuming process for the researchers. As you can see on the screen, Julia, who is an administrator, collaborates with her data engineers to enable project members to access and download their raw genomic sequence files. Marina is a data research analyst who wants to download those raw genomic sequence files from her project. To address this need, Julia can leverage the custom AWS Service Blueprint based Amazon S3 environment and configure action links, which provides Marina the familiar S3 browser interface from AWS console with access to specific S3 buckets and folders, and more importantly, using an AWS IAM role provided by Julia.
Now we will follow Julia as she works with a data producer to ingest raw genomic sequence files as data assets in Amazon S3, and then navigate to DataZone portal to ensure the data is properly cataloged. She starts by checking the Amazon S3 location where data producer has ingested the sequence files. Julia logs into AWS console and navigates to Amazon S3. Julia inspects the Amazon S3 location to verify that all the sequence files are uploaded at a location which is built for a specific study. Julia then navigates back to Amazon DataZone, where she opened a portal which is pre-built to actually inspect if the sequence files are cataloged within the DataZone portal. Within the DataZone portal, Julia navigates to oncology research project and verifies that there's already a published asset called genomic sequence documents, which is actually pointing to the sequence files in S3. Julia then logs back into Amazon DataZone and then inspects the domain that was pre-created called life sciences. Julia then points to a blueprint, which is called custom AWS service blueprint, and enables the blueprint. Once the custom blueprint is enabled, Julia has several options to configure, including using pre-built console links, integrations, generating data sources, and subscription target using custom roles and configuring custom links. Julia navigates to AWS Service Blueprint and builds a new environment. And this new environment is called Genomics Study Explorer. For a project, Julia selects a pre-built project called Oncology Research. It is the same project that she just inspected where the sequence files were cataloged for findability. For the permissions role, Julia brings a pre-created role called Oncology Researcher role. This specific role is enabled to have read-only access for that specific bucket and that specific location that has all the sequence files. We select the region, and then we create an environment. Now, at this point, an environment is created based on custom AWS service blueprint, which actually points to one of the S3 locations, and that's how we're going to configure it. So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to create a customized AWS links, and we're going to point to a specific S3 bucket and provide a location. And in this one, we'll browse to the same folder that was created for that specific study. And we're going to choose that folder. So once the folder is selected for that specific environment called drug research, we're going to customize this, and I'm going to call this action as Genomics Explorer and customize it. So now at this point, we have a custom AWS service blueprint enabled. An environment is created called Genomics Study Explorer, which is using a specific project and a specific role that was pre-created, and is actually navigating to a specific Amazon S3 location, which consists of all the genomics sequence files. That's how Julia works with the data producer to ingest sequence files as data assets in Amazon S3, navigate to DataZone portal to ensure the data is properly cataloged, and then custom environment is built so that Marina can then access Amazon S3 location using custom environment link with a Amazon DataZone project.
Marina, a data research analyst associated with the oncology research project, logs into the DataZone portal. Within the DataZone portal, Marina navigates to the oncology research project. This project has genomic sequence files cataloged as custom assets, which are essentially pointers or references to the actual files stored in an Amazon S3 location. These files are part of a specific study conducted within oncology research project. The DataZone portal allows members of the oncology research project to add additional metadata to these genomic sequence files. This metadata can be used to enhance discoverability and accessibility of the files, making it easier for researchers to find and request access to the relevant data. To facilitate seamless access to the Amazon S3 location containing the genomic sequence file, as you saw earlier, Julia has already done the setup using custom AWS service blueprint. Marina then navigates to the Environments tab and clicks on the Genomic Study Explorer link. This action launches an Amazon S3 location containing the genomic sequence files. This integration between the DataZone portal and the AWS environment allows researchers like Marina to efficiently access and work with the data they need without having to navigate to specific AWS console or manage multiple access credentials.
The combination of the DataZone portal, custom asset management, and the custom AWS service blueprint environment enables researchers in the oncology research project to streamline their data access and exploration process, fostering a more collaborative and efficient research environment. Thank you.